Morning. First of all, thank you very much for invitation to the ICETA 2016. It's my great pleasure to be there next time. MOOCs in SP4CE case studies is the title of my presentation. SP4CE stands for Strategic Partnership for Creativity and Entrepreneurship. The runtime of the project is September 2014 until August 2017. The project is supported by Erasmus+. We've got 6 partners and 2 of them are from Košice, Slovakia. The coordinator is from Warsaw and also the second partner from Poland is from Gdańsk. We've got two more partners from Hungary and Greece. Our case study team is presented on the right-hand side and they are students from Gdańsk University of Technology and Gdańsk Medical University. The project SP4CE aims at design and elaboration of innovative common tools for collaboration between students, enterprises and schools. We expect the main impacts of the SP4CE as follows. Students have an opportunity to learn about enterprises' activities and they can interact with coaches. They are able to enter the labor market having real professional experience. Enterprises receive required knowledge and possibility to recruit students who have concrete skills and competences. Here is a portal we developed especially for the project. And then you can find some options as guides, learning rooms, learning materials, conferences, and also contacts with us. The portal is prepared in 5 languages, so it's easy just to communicate in Slovak or Polish or English. Here is just an example of learning materials, and some of them were made by our organization. And especially I'm very proud of this part in connection with MOOCs and open educational resources. Here's learning rooms in Moodle and we've got almost 18 learning rooms, so it's quite a large number. The majority was developed by Promet and especially in connection with different conferences. We also tested different tools that you can use in learning rooms and you can see among forum chats, wiki, assignments, workshops and supporting materials, the majority of users are interested in 2 of them, so in forums and supporting materials. Okay, come back to local administrator, which is really important because after the project is ended, it's really a good idea to be able to go on with the environment with your own administrator. So as you can see, both implementation, portal and also learning rooms, they've got a local administrator from Poland, Slovakia, Greece and Hungary. And here is an example learning room devoted to ICETA 2016, our presentation I made with my students, and it was done within this learning room. Now I'm coming to the main topic. It's about MOOCs and SP4CE project. In fact, for the first time, MOOCs appears in training modules strengthening competences with MOOCs. This module contains the definition, history of development and examples of good practice connected with massive open online courses. Training materials will be available on portal in 5 languages. Learning rooms were developed in Moodle and they need also a local administrator. And in fact, it's possible to use MOOCs for administrative training. Here is an example certificate that one of our administrators has got from teaching with Moodle. And this MOOC takes part each year, so it's possible to join. The next MOOC we decided to take part in is Fusion 360. Up till now we've got 2 certified users, and this MOOC it's about 33-hour lectures, length of 4 hours, and this MOOC is available in English for different platforms. What is Fusion 360? It's a cloud-based CAD/CAM tool for collaborative product development, and it's free for students, educators, academic institutions. Using Fusion 360, students can develop their skills in order to become tomorrow's engineers, product designers, and industrial designers. We plan to develop MOOC Fusion 360 in SP4CE in Polish. The next our plan is developing MOOC Fusion 360 in EMA environment, which is European Multiply Aggregator, and it's really a lot of providers inside EMA. It can be the courses can be developed in different languages using tools developed within EMA. Here are example EMA providers, and one of them is our center from Gdańsk University of Technology. We also introduce our center at EMA, and you can just have a look what we are offering. Now I'm starting with our case study based on learning rooms. So we decided to create projects in the cloud environment using the idea of distance communication and giving the possibility of interdisciplinary cooperation between medical academic centers and technical institutions. It's obvious that transferring the communication and work to the clouds reduces the time of the project creation and realization. In our case, working in clouds enables diagnostic and medical consultation, surgical treatment planning, creating new solutions and methods, discussing the use of biocompatible materials. The case is like that. The patient comes to the doctor and gives the asymmetry within the right side of the face, and it is probably tumor. So after MDCG examination, it's observed that changes are really tumor. Next step is modeling treatment. Surgeons and engineers propose a solution that will remove the tumor. The next step is that an engineer translates 3D computed tomography for the Fusion 360 program in order to help design and print the implant. After this case study, my students decided just to prepare a special poster for invitation here to Gdańsk for ET conference, which will be held in April 2017. So welcome to Gdańsk, and here is invitation from the conference organizers. Before the conference, we decided to organize workshop in connection with SP4CE project, and the workshop will be held on 26th of April. Thank you for your attention. Welcome to SP4CE portal, and see you in Gdańsk in April.